Hi folks, I'm here today as a narrator for what I'm going to call the sign of the Super Bowl. What it boils down to is this started last year. I'm not a sports fan at all, to be honest with you. I just don't really get into that kind of thing. But I'm a big fan of the Lord, and when the Lord starts pointing to things, even if it's sports, if it's of interest to Him, then it tends to draw my interest too. The Lord showed me, I thought that the Lord showed me last year, well, actually the year before, I guess, slightly, that He was going to do a sign in starting with the Super Bowl, and I was wondering what it was about, and it turned out he showed me that the Giants were going to win the Super Bowl, which obviously they did. It's history now. What he is doing is he is putting a sign in front of the world that they can't miss because it's a spectacle. That's what the world looks for, is an entertainment and a spectacle, and there's none bigger than the Super Bowl in current time, in current years. Anyway, the Giants winning the Super Bowl over the Patriots is concerning the return of the Giants of old. They will be Giants, beast men. Anyway, what the world would have considered super soldiers. They've done it before. This thing has been instigated before, and it's going to be instigated again. And it's going to come forth with a bloodiness during the time of the tribulation. The reason it will be during the time of the tribulation is according to 2 Thessalonians, and I'll get into that in a minute. But anyway, I'll try and make this quick because, as I said, I'm just narrating something, and you're going to have to pray about it, see for yourself. The world will have to be shown, and when they're under attack, they will be. But it can't be that they say that the Lord did not warn us, that this thing came upon us and God didn't have the mercy to speak to us and tell us it was gonna happen. Even those that claim they don't believe in God know there is one in their heart of hearts. They just don't want to admit it. Anyway, I thought that was pretty much the end of it, but according to the way that the scripture is laid out, it says that by the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word must be established. So God confirmed His word. He confirmed what His sign. Giants won the Super Bowl. Another team named Giants followed up winning the World Series. And then a team called the Heat won basketball's highest trophy. What that meant was the Giants are coming, and they're bringing trouble. They're bringing big trouble. The Antichrist is listed as the beast, and the funny thing of it is even people will look at him and say, who is like the beast, and who can make war with him? That tells you a couple different things. One, he isn't offended at being called a beast, apparently. And two, in order to make war with somebody, there has to be armies involved. So he isn't alone. He will have beasts with him, so to speak. And maybe literally, beast men. Anyway, we have known that this kind of research has been going on in secret places, you know, for some time. What we haven't heard a whole lot about is that there are demonic influences that have been kind of manipulating things from behind the scenes. And man doesn't realize what he's playing with. That shouldn't surprise us. We've had many, many movies about things, you know, where genetics research has gotten out of hand and come back to bite us. Anyway, well, I thought that that was what the Lord was going to do, and I wasn't sure. Well, the Lord spoke to me again, you know, back about the time that the playoffs started. And I turned around and asked my son and his friend, this is Baltimore in the playoffs? And they said, yep, they're there, but they're not going to win. I says, I wouldn't bank on that. What do you mean? Oh, they don't have a chance. I says, yeah, if the Lord's holding their hand, they do. And this is the scripture that came to mind. And it is out of Revelation chapter 19. And it starts at verse 17 and 18. And it says, then I saw an angel standing in the sun, and he cried with a loud voice, saying to all the birds that fly in the midst of heaven, come and gather together for the supper of the great God, that you may eat the flesh of kings, the flesh of captains, the flesh of mighty men. Mighty men in Genesis chapter 6 was a term used to describe the giants. The flesh of horses and of those who sit on them. In other words, those who command power, because horses are a symbol of power in Scripture. And the flesh of all people, free and slave, both small and great. And when this scripture came to mind, in light of football, it dawned on me, well, that can't mean anything in football. Nobody's going to name their teams after carrion birds. They're named after, you know, after predators, after, you know, things, you know, that are considered powerful or cool or historically, you know, something grand, you know, Broncos, Colts, you know, different things like that, power, things that denote power or majesty or whatever. And it dawned on me, Baltimore has the Ravens, and Ravens are carrion birds. And that's when I asked my son, is Baltimore in the playoffs? And he said yes. Well, right now the Super Bowl is going on. It just barely started. So I'm not really saying a whole lot to say at the beginning of the game that Baltimore's going to win it. But if Baltimore doesn't win it, then you can disregard everything I'm saying. You know, it doesn't carry any weight unless Baltimore wins. I would prefer to see 49ers win, but I don't think it's going to happen that way. Anyway, that is the sign at the end of the time of the giants that will be revealed during the tribulation. The giants will run roughshod. They will slaughter. It is literally going to be warfare and slaughter. And that's scriptural. I'm going to bring that out here in just a minute. This is going to take place. And it says of the beast that he will make war with the saints. This is in Revelation. And will prevail. The saints will fall before him. And all the nations will be looking at him, and men will say, you know, who is like the beast? Who can make war with him? Well, we know that the giants were opposed in the previous Super Bowl by the Patriots. And I think that's representative of all of the Patriots of the nations that will try and bring this invasion, so to speak, under control. It's not going to happen. The Patriots will fall. The Giants will prevail. They will continue to prevail until Jesus comes in and puts a halt to it. He will destroy them. And it isn't going to be the saints that will rejoice over them. It will be the carrion birds, the buzzards, so to speak, the ravens. Oh, and by the way, the ravens, this is not the first time God used ravens in Scripture. He's done it before. A raven was the first bird that Noah sent out from the ark. Ravens fed Elijah. Ravens fed Elijah for 2 of the 3 years that the drought took place in Israel. You can check Scripture on it. If it hadn't been for the ravens feeding Elijah, then he would have gone hungry. That was how the Lord provided for him. Anyway, so if you're saying this is what's going to take place, then why isn't it already happening? That goes back to 2 Thessalonians. I told you I'd get back to it. 2 Thessalonians. I'm going to start in chapter 2, verse 5. Do you not remember that when I was still with you, I told you these things? And now you know what is restraining, that he may be revealed in his own time. Talking about the man of sin, which folks largely look at and say, oh, that's the Antichrist. It is, but it also could be a species, a man of sin, a kind of man who was spawned from sin in the first place and is predisposed to it in such a way that even men who have fallen from grace don't understand. Because men who have fallen from grace are of the seed of Adam, and they still have the residue from taking of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. They have a conscience. These giants don't. And that's what makes them wicked beyond wicked that we've ever seen. You know what is restraining, that he may be revealed in his own time. It's the Holy Spirit that's restraining. For the mystery of lawlessness is already at work. Only he who now restrains will do so until he is taken out of the way. Who will do that? Jesus will, when he comes in, takes his church out. He will take the Holy Spirit with him, and there will suddenly be no more restraint on the powers of the earth, and they will bring forth what has been hidden. And it will attack. There will be an out-and-out invasion. It will appear to come from below the ground. It may be put out they may put out a bunch of hoopla that they're coming down from space, but if they are, that's a lie. That's not what's happening. They may be coming out of the air, but they're not coming from space. They are coming from the prince of the power of the air. And then the lawless one will be revealed. You could say lawless ones, because I believe there's a whole lot more than one. You don't make war with a person. You make war with an army. Whom the Lord will consume with the breath of his mouth and destroy with the brightness of his coming. Paul doesn't glorify this guy and his army. He just says outright, this guy's going to come for. When he does, the Lord will destroy him. But there will be a few years intervening, and in the meanwhile, it's going to be bad. There's a reason the angel comes out in Revelation and says, woe unto the inhabitants of the earth, for the devil has come down to you full of wrath, for he knows he only has a short time. Anyway, and of course it goes on a little bit more. The coming of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan with all power, signs, and lying wonders, and with all unrighteous deception among those who perish, because they did not receive the love of the truth that they might be saved. Anyway, the last part of this is out of Joel. I told you it was scriptural. But we haven't understood what we read. And this is what I have been instructed to read. This is out of the book of Joel. It's chapter 3, verses 9, 10, and 11. Proclaim this among the nations. Prepare for war. Wake up the mighty men. Remember I told you mighty men was code word from Genesis chapter 6 for the giants. Wake them up. Let all the men of war draw near. Why? Because the giants are attacking. Let them come up. Beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong. We have taken that to mean that the church is to say, to ignore their weakness and say that the Lord is making us strong. That's not in context with what's being put here. It says, let the weak say, I am strong. In other words, the nations will say, well, we created this. Let the weak say, I am strong. In other words, these nations that created this business or think they did. Says, well, we brought it about. We can bring it under control. And Scripture is making it very clear that you're still the nations that think they've let that they've opened Pandora's box can close it again, and they're weak. They don't have the strength to do it. But there will be conflict. I mean, when you see what the giants are doing, it's utterly wicked. They're going to be doing some bad stuff. For one thing, they're going to be, it basically boils down to cannibalism. And if that doesn't make you think, I don't know what will. Remember what Jesus, what the scripture said about Jacob, the time of Jacob's trouble. That there will never be another time, that there has never been a time like this, and there will never be another time as terrible as this. I'm not telling you this to scare you. I'm telling you to give you a heads up as to what's coming. I'm going to be with the Lord. This cannot happen until the rapture takes place. But once it does, it's going to happen very quickly, and it's going to continue to happen for years. Those who thought that they said that the first half of the tribulation was going to be largely peaceful until the Lord started, letting loose plagues on the earth. It isn't, we're not warned against the plagues. The plagues are for these giants. Because God is so taken with rage at what they have done to humanity created in His image. The plagues are not for mankind. The plagues are made for these beings. Anyway, let the weak say, I am strong. Assemble and come, all you nations, and gather together all around. Cause your mighty ones to go down there, O Lord. These giants are going to come forth, and when it happens, it's going to be fast, it's going to be very, very bloody, and it's going to spread. It's going to spread hugely. Remember what said that in Revelation, it says that blood will flow like a river up to the horses' bridles. That's an awful lot of bloodshed. and it's not going to all take place at one shot at the end of the tribulation period. It's going to build. Anyway, last part of this, as I said, I'm just narrating. This is something that the Lord is bringing forth, and I don't have any control over it. Some can say that the Super Bowls are rigged and this, that, and the other, and it may be. I don't know. But I know what the Lord showed me, that these are the people who are going, you know, that this is the sign that's taking place. I'm going to take you back in Joel, one chapter. And I'm going to start at verse 30 and go through verse 32. People are going to cry out to the Lord because of this, because of how bad it's going to be. And even though he who restrains has been taken out of the way, the Lord will give him back again for folks that cry out. I'm going to go back a few scriptures more. I'm going to say verse 28. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Talking about a vision where Jesus will come in and bring justice, where justice seems to have disappeared. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions, and also on my men servants and on my maid servants I will pour out my spirit in those days. Yeah, on his servants. And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness. Remember that pillars of smoke kind of brings something back to mind about the bottomless pit being opened and smoke rolling out of it. This is kind of in context with that. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the coming of the great and awesome day of the Lord. And it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there shall be deliverance, as the Lord has said, among the remnant whom the Lord calls. Where it says, it shall come to pass that whosoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Repentance is always vital in being accepted before the Lord. He can't provide atonement if you don't own up to your sin and repent for it. What the scripture is saying here is whoever calls on the name of the Lord will be saved, because that's all they have time to do before they're destroyed. It's not a nice message, but I'm narrating what I believe the Lord has shown me. And destruction is going to be loosed so quickly from these giants and these beast beings coming on the earth as an invasion force. It's going to come up and they're going to kill indiscriminately. Jesus made it kind of clear, you know, from what he said, that if the days were not shortened, no flesh would be saved. You'd either join them or you'd be devoured by them. That is the threat. The threat is genocide of the human race. And it's going to be a very real threat. It's going to come about that it's going to people are going to be faced with it without much more warning than what I'm giving right now. Anyway, the sign of the Super Bowl is for the world. The time now is to turn to the Lord. But for those who have to see for themselves, Whoever calls on the name of the Lord will be saved, even if you're going into the mouth of whatever is devouring you at the time. If you're legitimate in crying out to the Lord, He will honor it. He said it right here. He gave His word on it. And there's one thing you can count on with God, and that is that He keeps His word. Anyway, I'm not going to tie you up any more than that. I just wanted to put this out. I felt like I needed to put this out. The sign of the Super Bowl for a world that wants to see spectacle. And God put it in the spectacle right in front of their eyes. And He gives you hope that the Giants will be destroyed, even though there won't be a whole lot of humanity left around to see it. Oh, and those who think to profit on it will fall, just like the Miners 49ers that dropped everything to go looking for gold, that the San Francisco is named after, the San Francisco team is named after, will not profit by it any more than the 49ers are going to overcome the Ravens. And I'm not a fan, to be honest with you, of either. I truthfully would prefer to see the 49ers win for the simple fact that that means you can disregard everything here that I've said, that I was talking out of my hat. Because even if I'm not here, I'm still human, and I still feel the pain that's going to come around from all of this. And you can't be the Lord's man or woman and not share in His compassion. This is not something I would wish off on my worst enemy, but I'm calling it like I see it. Anyway, love you, brethren. God bless those who don't believe in Christ. Keep your eyes open and don't take the mark of the beast. And may the Lord spare you. God bless. Bye-bye.